Welcome to Dr. David Eifrig's Health and Wealth Bulletin. This is Weekly Update. This week, we've gotten a lot of questions from our subscribers regarding artificial sugars and whether or not they're really dangerous. That's why today we want to touch on a few points you need to know the next time you reach for something sweet. The first is that all artificial sugars do cause three main problems: inflammation, which we know is associated with different diseases like cancer, possibly Alzheimer's disease. The second is fat formation. The reason for this is because when you consume artificial sugars, they're tricking your body into thinking there are extra calories coming. It's because regular sugar is often associated with that. However, these artificial sugars lack the same calorie content. That makes you more hungry and often leads to overeating. Part of the problem with fat formation is the third issue. Your gut microbiome actually changes. Now remember, your gut microbiome are all of the bacteria that live in your intestines. These bacteria are really important because they do everything from breaking down your food to regulating your immune system and even your moods. That's why you want to take really good care of them. The problem is artificial sugars change which bacteria are thriving, and they can often set you up for some really terrible effects. In fact, in a 2014 study, they saw that artificial sugar actually changed your gut bugs and increased glucose intolerance. Now, glucose intolerance is important because when you can't process your blood sugar or the glucose properly, that can lead to things like type 2 diabetes. Now, there are four main types of artificial sugars that we want to cover today. And they're in everything from the packets that you put in your coffee to added sugars in things like processed foods. So here are the four that you need to look for. The first is aspartame. The common brand name for this is Equal. You can often find it in things like Diet Coke and other diet sodas. Now, the problem with aspartame, in addition to the three problems we mentioned earlier, is that it also causes headaches and can actually decrease your sex drive. The second is saccharin. Saccharin is the common name of sweet and low. Now, saccharin, in addition to those three things again, causes problems with weight gain. And saccharin is often found in any diet processed foods. So anytime you see a processed food on the shelf that says it's a diet version, chances are it contains saccharin. The third one is sucralose. This goes by the name Splenda. Now, in addition, of course, it still causes inflammation and problems with your gut microbiome, but sucralose also increases your blood pressure. And as we wrote in a recent issue, Splenda is becoming more and more commonly used, particularly in candy and other confections. Now, the fourth type is stevia, and this is the only one that we really recommend should you want an artificial sweetener. The only problem with stevia, which goes by the name Truvia, is that there is some evidence it can increase your blood pressure. However, it doesn't tend to affect your blood sugar as much because your body processes it almost the same as sugar. So for our next point, there's another type of sugar we want to talk about. It's called trehalose, and it's derived from a lot of plant-based products. Now, for many years, we couldn't afford to use too much trehalose, so we didn't really understand the dangers of it. But right around 2000, they came up with a cheaper way of producing it, and since then, it has been put into so many products, everything from ground beef to frozen vegetables. Now, the reason we're concerned is because a study that published this year in the journal Nature demonstrated that since we started adding trehalose to our food supply, there's been a huge increase in the number of deaths from the superbug C. diff. Now, the researchers doing the study found out that there are a few types of C. diff in particular that actually thrive on trehalose. So what you're doing when you're eating a lot of food that contains the sugar is you're feeding those dangerous bugs in your gut. Unfortunately, C. diff can cause things like diarrhea or colitis, but if you're elderly or especially if you have a compromised immune system, it can even lead to organ failure and death. In fact, between the years of 1999 and 2007, we've seen a five-fold increase in deaths from C. diff. And these researchers are thinking that's because we have greatly increased our intake of trehalose. Now, given all of these problems, both with artificial sugars and trehalose, we always want to encourage you to read the ingredients list of anything you purchase. Now, a good rule of thumb is to always avoid processed food and anything that says light, diet, or low carb. But if you can't do that, always, always check the ingredients list for all of these sugars and try to avoid them when you can. That's it for now. Don't forget to keep your comments and questions coming to our feedback line. Like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.